G'day guys, back again. If you just saw my last video, I was just posting this one up to just, I was going through a couple of parts, but I thought my video might go for too long. So I just thought I'd do the parts in this section here, or this video. And I've just basically picked out some of the parts that I thought were, you know, pretty interesting. All those little guards and the shields on the ankles and stuff, you know. There's not much to them. I'll show you one or two of them. But now, as you know, when some of these 3D models, some of the companies, you know, the printing stubs and are pretty woeful. And at first I thought these were all the printing stubs, but they're just the little, you know, just the actual rivets or whatever you like. And they're actually done really nicely. Not really many lines in this. So, you know, like you can sort of see them, but you can't feel them. But underneath here, you can see a little bit, which isn't really going to matter too much, but you can obviously where they've printed this from, and you can see all the little supports that you've had to cut off. But given that that's sitting underneath, and I did go through the whole model and have a look at, you know, where all these supports are, and most of them are in logical or modeler friendly places, if you like, but this is going to sit that way. But if you can see the little details inside there, that's probably about as close as I get for you guys. But you know, that's pretty nice, isn't it? Look at the little padding. You can almost see the texture of the padding here on the sides of the you know, there, of the cushioning, if you like. And over this side it sort of shows up as well. And even this sort of this grill, it's done nicely. It's pretty amazing these days. I mean, for the last year or so I've been really tempted to get a 3D printer to just build some things that, you know, as a modeler you really want, but yeah, there's files for, but you know, no one else is bringing them out. And I'm really sort of tempted to do, you know, like the Horizon Mad Cat, the Battletech kits of the vinyl ones that I think I've showed you a video of, to build something like that, a large scale kit. So it'd be quite expensive with a lot of parts, but it's just one of those things that I like, and you just don't get big mechs anymore. So I'm just pretty keen to build one of those, and then I'll probably end up making a mold of it and casting it for myself to make a couple more rather than 3D printing it. I'd rather, you know, go the old resin route probably, and then just once I make the actual thing, then I'll cast a couple up for myself. This one here, again, you can see all the sort of rivets and everything like that, and the handles are done nicely and everything like that. And as you'll see when I just flip this over, you can tell they've sort of done that on this side, and then on this side you'll again see all the little parts that are, you'll probably have to clean up a little bit, but again, I think this part and this part here where you've got these bits will sort of sit on top of each other, something like that. So even though you've got, you do have to do a bit of a clean up inside there. Once you sit this sort of down nice and firm, you're not going to see too much of it. And turn it around a little bit like that. And obviously on the front part, there's another part that goes in there, but I just thought I'd show you that. But underneath, that's why that's done so like that. So it's not totally no cleanup. Just some little finer parts here. Again, the little, you know, cockpit sort of dashboard or whatever you want to call it, instrument panel. Again, you've got the little attachment points underneath there, but you're not going to see those. So on top. Yeah, and the fact that this is all pretty much cut out for you, I think probably cleaning up, you know, these sort of bits isn't that bad, because you're not sort of cutting every part off like a normal plastic kit off a sprue, then, you know, cleaning the edges up and everything like that. So I actually think this will be quite a quick kit to put together. Another part that I quite liked, if you weren't going to put the figure in, which I will be, it's just the little, it's quite weird for, like, I don't know, like, it's, yeah, I suppose it's, you know, 46, but it's like a modern version. Sort of reminds you of something like an Aliens dropship seat or something like that, but then they've got the old sort of cushioning style work put into it. But again, it's there. I mean, my figure's going to sit on there, but if you were going to have the figure, and even on the back there, look at that, that's pretty nice. Got a couple of supports in there, and obviously underneath, but obviously again you're not going to see those. Nice little seat though. Quick look at one of the feet. Again, All the parts are done nicely. You've got the, again, underneath that, but that's going underneath the foot. So not really much cleanup there, especially if you're going to have that sitting in some mud or some grass or anything like that. I'll get to the figure in a second. But again, you've got a nice little couple of attachment points under there. But at the front here, all nice little detail. Show you one more part before we get to the figure. I mean, you can't complain about that. That's a nice part. Actually, I'll have to bring back the the main part of the body just to show you the size of it. I normally do that for you guys. And here's the figure here. Again, you've got your nice little attachment points to make it easy to put the arms in. And you've got the little things here for that, for his arms. I like his little sort of body armor suit there, or whatever it is. And his little... I just really like that. I wish they'd just continue this sort of uniform on his arms. It's just weird to see his arms like with just a short sleeve shirt on. And... you know, and then just bare flesh. I would have liked if they had a bit of padding like this, you know, like a stormtrooper on down on his arms as well. I really like his sort of where his eyes are, and you know, his goggles over the top or whatever, you know, part of his mask. Just the texturing near his knees there. Very cool figure. I really like this figure. And this is sort of where, you know, the pictures always look nice and great box art, everything like that. But, you know, when you're paying, you know, quite a bit for a kit, maybe about, what was it, up to, I think it's up near around the $200 mark. The painful part of it, and I'll bring a little skip over, is that, you know, you're basically looking, apart from the barrels, obviously, you know, the kits, and there might be one or two add-on parts at the back, but this main part is, you're looking at, is about 6 centimeters long. And you know, you're looking about the width here, you know, with that, without the guns on it, is about 4 centimeters long. So it's a very, you know, expensive kit for the size, but as I said, I really liked the design of it. And I think they sort of, you know, the metal barrels and, you know, I mean, I can talk all day long. It's an expensive kit. I think if it wasn't traded for something else, I definitely wouldn't have picked it up for that price. But because I had two of one kit and I've traded it for something else. But if you like me and you like your mechs, maybe you'll fall in love with it and you'll just go, oh, to hell with it. I'm going to pick it up. But very expensive. But a lovely little kit for what it is. Leave me a comment, guy. Let me know what you think. As always, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.